In this lecture, I'll be talking about very basic algebraic expressions and their simplification, and also bring how to solve linear or nonlinear equations. So let me take one example where you can see the radical sign on 180 and also on 80. So we need to simplify this one, but we need to find the exact answer, no approximation. So divide by 2 because it's even number, so you get 90. Now we know that I have another number here, which is 2. I can get 45, and then I know that I can divide it by 9. So 9 is a squared number, and I have a 5 here. So then you can say 180 is just 2 times 2, and here you can get a 3. So you can take 3 times 3 squared times 2 squared times 5. This is same as 180. So this number now we can say is 3 times 2 square root of 5. Same way square root of 80. If you already know, then you can go like this, 16 times 5. 16 is a squared number, it come out as a 4, and 5 will stay, so you get 4 radical 5. This one is 6 radical 5 minus 4 radical 5, so you get 2 radical 5. That's the simplified one. You can take another example, so that you have a square root of 162 minus the square root of 8. Now we are looking for some squared numbers. So you have 162, you can divide it by 2, so you get 8 and then 1. And you know that 9 times 9, 9 is squared. So I can do like this. So from this 9 times 9, you can just take 9 and 2 will be here. And then from 8, you can write this one as 4 times 2. That gives you 2 radical 2. So then your final answer is 7 radical 2. So the first example you have, you can write radical 2 over radical 5. Since we need to rationalize here, radical 5 is irrational number. You want to rationalize it, so multiply numerator denominator by 5. So in the denominator now you get just 5, because radical 5 times radical 5. In the numerator you can just write square root of 10. So our denominator is rationalized now. 5 is a rational number. This one you can simplify first. Radical 4 will give you 2, and then radical 7. And then multiply numerator denominator by radical 7. You get a 7 here, 2 radical 7. You are done also with that one. Next, this. This one, if you want to simplify first, it look like this. 3 radical 3. You know that. Because the square root of 27 is the square root of 9 times 3. So 9 goes in front as a 3, and then it's a 3 here. If you want to rationalize now, you can multiply numerator, denominator just by radical 3, because we need that one to remove. Now, this one, when you multiply, will be 3. So 3 times 3 is 9. And in the top, you get radical 3. So you got rationalized. We are now taking two equations. The first one is 3x plus 5 by minus 13 equals 12, which is linear. And then we are taking another non-linear, negative x squared plus y squared minus 3x plus 7 equals 10. And we want to find y for both the cases. So when you do this one here, you write 5y, and other terms you need to move on the right side. So 3x is in the left side as a positive. So with the reverse operation, you take it here as a negative. 5y you are keeping, negative 13 will move other side as positive 13, and 12 is already there. So then if you further simplify, you get negative 3x plus 25. Now we need to find y, so we divide both sides by 5. This is reverse operation again. Each term we can divide by 5, so you get this plus 5. So then we have solved our equation in terms of x. So y is written in terms of x. This is called explicit form now. And this is the equation of a straight line where slope is negative 3/5 and y-intercept is 5. Now let us look at that one. So you know this is quadratic. So if you want to solve for y, the same way we need to isolate y squared on the left side first. So you got y squared equals with the reverse operation. X squared I have negative, so I move it to right side with the positive sign. 3x will go as a positive on this. Negative 7 and 10 I have already there. So then y squared is x squared plus 3x plus 3. Now what is y? So y will be with a square root, but don't forget a plus or minus sign. So you got x squared plus 3x plus 3. So you got basically two forms, y equals square root of x squared plus 3x plus 3. And the second one you can say y equals minus x squared plus 3x plus 3. Let us plot these equations in the calculator. So as we said, this is the equation of a straight line. So you can type y1, which is for y, negative 3/5 x plus 5. And then take the standard window. You can go to zoom 6. That will give you standard window. So this is the equation of the straight line. And clearly you can see the slope is negative. So it goes like that. And you go to the second one now. You want to make this one on the right side. How do you type this one? First you go to second, x squared. That gives you the radical sign. Then you type x squared and then plus 3x plus 3. And then the second one goes with a negative sign. Second square root. Then you have x squared plus 3x plus 3. Let's try with the standard window first. So we have already standard window. It goes like this. This is a hyperbola. So this is the equation of a hyperbola, and we can see it here. Thank you.